Biff's Gaming Videos. Joysticks and joypads.
Trackballs and mouse pads.
Swimmers and my guns.
Fun.
Alien invasions.
Robotic invasions.
Dungeons and dragons.
Fun.
Home runs and touchdowns.
Jungles and ghost towns.
Videos from Biff Sun.
Fun.
Whenever you talk about Dragon's Lair, you need to talk about the different variations that impacted the game. For example, the platform. Was it the Cinematronics arcade version? Or was it the licensed out to Atari in Europe? Or was it the Italian version that Atari sub-licensed it out to? Was it the Atari Jaguar home platform? Or was it an IBM PC? Depending on what platform and what system it came out, some things may be slightly different. Now, within the platform, there are different versions. For example, on the IBM PC, they released the first version, and years later, they released the anniversary edition. So there may be differences, and I'm saying that there are. I'm saying that there may be differences depending on what version of the game from a particular platform that it came out for. Now, an extension of that is the ROM version in the arcade, and also the DIP switches. DIP switches are little switches inside the old arcade machines. They're kind of like light switches that go up or down. And you can change like the number of lives that Dirk has, 3 or 5, or you know how much money it costs to play. You know, they put different things like that on DIP switches. But the ROM version, like ABCD, well, they came out with a version of the ROM. The ROM is a chip with the computer program on. And then you also have the laserdisk. Well, the laserdisk has the video that gets played back, the movie. The ROM is the program that determines how the game is played and what gets played back and when. So it just plays back different scenes at certain times. So version A, B, C, D, E, F, F2, Beta 1, Beta 2, the Atari European version, all these would have maybe possibly slightly different versions of the game. For example, the drawbridge is in some versions at the beginning of the game and other versions not even played in the game. So it really depends on the ROM version. And this is the biggest thing for scene variations. When the scenes come up is the ROM version. Some systems make all the scenes one after another, kind of linear. Other versions are more random. It just depends on the ROM version. Now the difficulty settings in the arcade, the Cinematronics version, you had easy, hard, and very hard. Most of the examples will be easy. In fact, most of the machines should be easy level. Hard level, the timing of up, down, left, right, when you have to do things, is less. So it's tougher to play. Plus, some of the moves are not in the easy version that they add in the hard version. So it's a lot harder. Very hard is insanely difficult. And it's really not even useful. I mean, in fact, hard's not even useful. You only need easy. The game is tough enough as it is. But I guess they threw in a hard and a very hard. But you'll never see very hard. Almost everyone will be easy. And if you ever find a hard machine, you won't even know it. It's very rare to find something like that. The scene sequencing depends on the ROM version and also the difficulty settings, as I just talked about. So the scenes will come up in different orders depending on the platform and the ROMs and so forth. So I'm going to give you the scene sequences how it is in the arcade version, but it may be slightly different. And in fact, I know it's different depending on what ROMs it is. So I'm going to give you the standard stuff, and then you can adjust from there. Now, the scoring is something that the arcade version had, where when you start a scene, you get points, and then as each move goes, you get more points. So there's a way to get a score. Now, whether or not that's useful, no one really knows or cares. I mean, I remember being a kid, all matter was is getting through the game. The score didn't matter. But there is a scoring that is on the arcade version. Now, when you play Dragon's Lair, there's movement. You have up, down, left, right, and a sword button. What I'm going to go over here is the arcade version from Cinematronics, easy difficulty. U is up, D is down, L is left, and R is right, and S is sword. Now these can be buttons, or they can be joystick, it could be keyboard, it doesn't matter. It could be, you know, mouse clicking left or right, it doesn't matter. These are the 5 things that you had in the arcade version. Sometimes, no move is the correct move, so I put an N there. Normally, if you don't do anything, you get killed, but there are a few situations that doing nothing is the proper thing to do. So, an N is no move. Now, an easy setting, there are some moves that aren't there, whereas in hard setting, there are. So I put an X there for easy setting. For example, if hard setting had a left and easy setting had nothing, it would be an X under easy setting. Because in easy setting, you do nothing, but in hard setting, you do L for left. And that's what the X is. Now, sometimes I give multiple moves, like UR or UL. Now, what these are is multiple moves are correct. For example, UR, up or right, is correct. UL, up or left, is correct. US is up or sword, is correct. So on some of the moves in some places, you can do more than one thing. You know, you can do up or right. Most of these, like up, right, you can do diagonal and it'll be good. There are times where the diagonal doesn't work, so I didn't include these in the settings because I didn't want to have too much stuff to confuse you all. Now, the scoring is very basic and simple. For the rope scene here, you get 49 points to start the scene and you go right four times. Get 251, 379, 495, 915, and if you finish the scene without getting killed, you get 2,089 points. Now, obviously, if you get killed midway through it, you don't get the full amount of points. You only get some points. But before the finishing the game, you have to finish this level. So you go back and you play it again at some point. But that's the scoring. You know, you get one for the scene start, and then each move you get points. And I will explain those as the game goes on. So obviously, some levels that have more moves get more points. Scene sequencing is how the scenes come up in the particular version of the game. We're going to talk about the arcade version, Cinematronics USA version. Now, within the different ROMs, the scene sequencing is different. So, depending on what platform you're on, it's going to be different. What I'm going to show you is the basic one, and then you can just adjust it from there. The LaserDisc starts off with a castle intro, the wide shot of the castle, and then it does a drawbridge, and he runs through the drawbridge, and gates close behind him. Some of the versions have the drawbridge first and other versions don't. Other versions just cut right past the drawbridge to him going through the gate and the gate closing behind him. So that's why row one there is up by itself because it may or may not be shown. Then you have row two, three, and row four. And actually we have 14 different rows. Now scene sequencing, here we have rows two, three, and four shown. We'll go like this. Row two, the computer will pick one of these three scenes, ropes, ropes reverse, or bedroom, to play. Now, if the first scene is the drawbridge, this will be the second scene. If the first scene is not the drawbridge, this will be this won't be the second scene, this will be the first scene. So that's why I have a two as a row two. So it randomly picks one of these three to play. Let's say it picks the bedroom. Once you finish the bedroom, it goes to row three, and it picks either flying, barding, flying barding reverse, or widget's kitchen. Now, by the way, flying barding is armor for a horse, in case you didn't know. Then it goes to the mausoleum reverse and also the underground river. It picks one of those three. So let's say it does bedroom, then it does flying barding, and then it's mausoleum. So it just picks one of those three from each row, from row two, then it goes to row three, it goes to row four, and goes all the way down through the game. As it plays the scene, it X's it off. So for example, the bedroom, it got played, it X's it off after you play it. It will not play it back again. Then it does flying barding. Let's say it picked that at random, row three. It X's it off and doesn't play it again. And then the mausoleum gets X'd off and doesn't play it again. And it goes through all the different rows like that. After you get through row 13, you will come to row 14. Row 14 is not random. Elevator floor 9 levels, the reverse in Dragon's Lair is not random. When you come down to row 14, it will always play the elevator floor 9 levels on the first sequence through, the first cycle. You have to finish the elevator floor 9 levels. It will not play it again later. So you keep playing it over and over and over until you win this particular level, until you complete this particular level. Then, when it's done, it goes back up to row 2. Row 2, it picks one of the two scenes that was not played before and plays one of those at random. Then it goes to row three. It picks one of those two that wasn't played before. Remember, they X'd off one as it plays each one from each row. Then it goes to row three and row four, all the way down to row 13. And it plays one of the two that hadn't played before. After row 13 in the second cycle, it comes down the elevator floor 9 levels reverse on the second cycle through. It does not do anything random on row 14. The second cycle, it will always play elevator floor 9 levels reverse. It'll keep playing it over and over and over and over until you finish that. On other levels, the other scenes, if you get killed, it goes on to the next row. Not here on row 14. Then what it does is it goes all the way back up to the top, the level 2, or row 2, I should say, and it does the one scene that was not played before, and it goes all the way down through until it gets down to row 14, this third cycle. Now, right before it plays the Dragon's Lair, it will then queue up all the scenes that you got killed on, that you didn't finish, and will play them back one at a time until you finish it. For example, if you didn't finish Flying Barding, it will play Flying Barding over and over and over here before the Dragon's Lair until you finish it. And let's say you had Mudman was the other one you didn't finish. It'll keep playing Mudman over and over and over and over. So it queues them all up right before the Dragon's Lair, and you get it plays them back in the order that it came, that you didn't finish it, over and over and over until you finish them. Then the last thing that's played is the Dragon's Lair. Now, on row 5, you've got elevator floor 3 levels twice, and you have the vestibule. Now, some versions, like the Atari Jaguar, the vestibule is always played after the drawbridge. So you go to the intro, drawbridge, vestibule, which is really how it is on the laserdisk. If you take a look at how it comes up on the laserdisk, that's how it is. So scene sequencing is a little different there. But if you take a look at the elevator floor, there's two different ones there. Now, this is the only level that gets played twice, ever. And it gets played twice. Once on when you come down 2 of the 3 cycles, it'll be played twice. The elevator floor 9 levels is exactly the same. In fact, the 3 levels here is the first 3 levels, the first few seconds of the 9 levels. It gets cut off. So they didn't really draw anything different. The 3 levels is the beginning of the 9 levels. So there are 4 elevator floors in the game. The 3 levels get played twice. It's exactly the same. And the 9 levels, which is normal and reverse, gets played once. The 3 levels, it's just like any other level. If you miss it, it keeps on going. If you get killed, it just keeps on going. If you take a look at the Grim Reaper, there's a reverse and a normal. Well, the Grim Reaper is a level, but the reverse is opposite. So whenever you come to something that's reversed, left is right and right is left. Or let's just pick any level. Let's say you go up, down, left, right. Well, in the reverse, it'd be up, down, right, left. The up and the down and the sword and everything else is exactly the same. The only thing, the difference on reverse, is left and right. They just reversed the two because it's been rotated 180 degrees. And that is everything you ever wanted to know about Dragon's Lair. From here on out, it's all scene sequencing. I will just do easy levels and it'll say easy setting. And if it's a hard or very hard, I'll indicate it on the side of the screen.